Hey guys, my name is Ryan. I'm the CEO here at Upkeep. Today's topic is all about predictive maintenance. What is it? We'll do a super deep dive into predictive maintenance. Cool. Let's go ahead and start out with the definition. So, predictive maintenance is a type of condition-based maintenance in which your equipment and assets are monitored with sensor devices that supply data. This type of data could be temperature, vibration, acoustic. All of this data is going to tell you what the condition of your piece of equipment is at. What you do with all this data is then you're going to put it into, it could be a machine learning algorithm to help you predict when that asset requires maintenance next. And the whole purpose and premise behind predictive maintenance is to help enable you figure out when a piece of equipment is going to break down before it actually does. This is different than breakdown maintenance because breakdown maintenance, you're basically waiting for a piece of equipment to fail before you actually perform maintenance on it. This is also different than preventative maintenance on a time-based schedule, like that filter change every 6 months. Predictive is all about predicting the optimal time of when you need to perform maintenance based on the condition of that piece of equipment or asset. So, there's a few steps in rolling out a predictive maintenance plan. Let's go ahead and jump right in. The first step that you really want to do with your team when implementing a predictive maintenance program is first establish what the baselines are. So we've purchased sensors, we have installed them on our equipment. The next thing that we want to do is figure out what are the high limit and low limit thresholds and the operating conditions of the optimal operating conditions of our equipment. Once we do that, we'll purchase our IoT devices, fixate them onto our equipment. So for example, that's that vibration meter fixated to a a gear or a pump, for example, or a temperature sensor attached to a boiler. The next thing that we want to do is connect this device to software. Whole purpose behind predictive maintenance is to be able to take action on it through the data, the operational data of your equipment. And then the last thing that you want to do is start scheduling maintenance. So we've identified the high limit and the low limit thresholds for, let's call it that temperature sensor. When it goes above a certain temperature or it goes below a certain temperature, we want to actually schedule maintenance on it because that's predicting when this piece of equipment is operating outside of its normal conditions. So these are four steps on how to implement your predictive maintenance program. So the first thing you want to do is establish your baseline, install IoT devices, start connecting your devices to software, and then start scheduling your maintenance. And you create this feedback cycle where you're constantly learning through the data that you have from your machines and sensors, and also the work and maintenance that your team is actually performing on this equipment. This is going to give you much better information and data on your assets and equipment to better help you understand the condition that it's in. Cool. Then the next thing that I want to touch upon is what's the ROI of predictive maintenance? We oftentimes hear that the return on investment is 10 times higher than working in a reactive or a breakdown maintenance mode. It's huge. The whole purpose and premise behind this is we are implementing a predictive maintenance program to reduce costly downtime. And we see this across the entire funnel in our facility. So this is going to reduce downtime. It's going to re reduce and eliminate breakdowns of your equipment. And it's also going to help you increase production at your facility. There's a huge ROI when implementing a predictive maintenance program. But the first thing that we always suggest to our customers and prospects is always thinking about, not just the effect of predictive maintenance, but also what is the cost to implement a predictive maintenance program. So the first thing that we always suggest is choose that one most critical asset that could have the biggest impact on your business and start there when rolling out a predictive maintenance program. Thanks.